Back here at home, the Marcos administration is providing up to 6 million housing units for qualified beneficiaries within 6 years. The Department of Human Settlements and Urban Development says the goal is to provide up to 1 million houses per year. Government data show the Philippines has a housing need of 6.5 million units.
Ito pong housing need, ito po ang nagpo-promote doon sa yung pagkakataon ng ating mga kababayan na maging successful sa kanilang buhay. Ano po? Nakatali po yung pagkakaroon ng bahay, pagkakaroon po ng shelter, yung pong pagkakaroon ng mabuting kalusugan at saka yung pagkakataon po makaangat sa buhay.
The House of Representatives approves a bill seeking to require SIM card registration on second reading. Vivian Gulia now on the line to tell us more. Viv?
Hi, Denise. The House of Representatives has approved on second reading the bill seeking to require the registration of SIM cards amid the prevalence of text scams. Under House Bill Number 14, every public telecommunications entity or PTE or direct seller shall require the end user of a SIM card to present a valid identification document with photo and require him to sign a control numbered registration form. Among the information that need to be registered are full name, date of birth, gender, and address. Government-issued IDs with photo will be considered valid identification. The registration form shall include an attestation by the end user that the person appearing before the direct seller is the same person who accomplished and signed the registration form and that the identification documents presented are valid and correct. Failure of an end user to comply with the requirements under this section shall be a ground for refusal to sell or issue a SIM card. The measure also provides that any information in the SIM card registration shall be treated as absolutely confidential unless access to information has been granted upon written request or written consent of the subscriber. But upon a duly issued subpoena or court order or upon written request from a law enforcement agency in relation to an ongoing investigation, the PTE shall be required to disclose the full name and address contained in the SIM card registration. In case of loss of a SIM card, the subscriber must notify the public telecommunications entity within 48 hours. The bill proposes a maximum fine of 300,000 pesos for the first offense, 500,000 pesos for second offense, and up to 1 million pesos per offense for third and subsequent offenses should a PTE fail to comply with the provisions of the bill. Denise, back to you.
Thanks, Viv. The Philippine Education Department set to come up with a new basic education curriculum. That's according to Vice President and DepEd Chief Sara Duterte. She says the agency finished reviewing the curriculum for kindergarten to grade 10, while the review for grades 11 to 12 is still pending.
We initially presented it to the MANCOM, EXECOM, and then we will present it to other sectors from the government and the private sector as well. And we are currently starting with the review on grades 11 to 12, and then it will go through the same process. It will go through presentations so that comments and suggestions from all the sectors can be collated by the Department of Education and we come up with the new curriculum for the K to 12 program.
But she clarifies, changes will not immediately take effect.
It will take 2 to 3 years for us to implement a new curriculum for the K to 12. And I am trying to push the curriculum and instruction strand to do it in 1 year.